A ver si se callan los vecinos. Ya. Bueno, voy a empezar esto sin pensarlo más, porque esta es como la décima vez, no, décima ya no, la que, no sé. Muchas veces que intento grabar esto y no me sale porque esto de ello y la cámara no es muy natural. Estáis más acostumbrados a verme las manos dibujando. Que empiezo en español para no tener que grabar esto 500 veces más porque en inglés... Luego cambiaré a inglés y lo subtitularé al español para que todos lo podáis entender. Nada, rápido... No sé si os acordáis de un tweet que puse hace medio año, no, más, hace un año o por ahí, que explicaba todos los pasos que seguía cuando hacía un dibujo con café. Pues esto es básicamente ese tweet, pero con un ejemplo. O sea, he usado el dibujo este que veis ahí, ahí, para como ilustrar todos esos pasos y así que podáis seguir el mismo proceso. No es un tutorial como tal, pero más o menos. Lo del tutorial, que es algo que me lleváis pidiendo mucho tiempo, sobre todo para la parte del café, lo haré más adelante cuando yo ya esté más naturalizada con el tema de la cámara y esto, que no creo que pase nunca, pero bueno, lo vamos a intentar. Y nada, que espero que entendáis todo el proceso y que si tenéis alguna duda o algo me escribáis en los comentarios. Ah, y bueno, que no me he presentado, soy Nuria, de nuriamarqart, en Instagram, Twitter y un montón de plataformas que no os voy a decir porque ya no uso. Realmente en Twitter, Instagram y ahora YouTube. Pues nada, voy a hacer una breve introducción en inglés para la gente que no hable español. Y luego de eso ya podéis seguir con el vídeo. Okay, so let me switch really quick to English. So I don't know if you remember a year ago, more or less, when I posted a tweet about all the steps I follow when I'm drawing with coffee. So this is basically that, but explaining it better using a drawing of mine, that one exactly. So it's not a full tutorial, but I'll do that soon. I know some of you want to know with more explanation what I do when I'm using coffee, but I'll try to do that when I'm more used to the camera. So I hope you enjoy this, and if you have any questions, leave me them below in the comments. So let's go. Okay, so first come first, we need to create our own reference picture. So no, I am not a magician and I don't draw them directly from my mind like some of you think I do. So what I usually do is I go on Pinterest and search there for a bunch of pictures. So when I am doing fan arts, I search for tour pictures or live performances or something like that, because you know I like pictures of them singing, and then save a lot of them and choose from that. So before moving on to Photoshop, I like to go through all the pics I saved and delete similar ones. I don't know how, but I always end up with too many pics of the same day. Okay, so that was the easy part, and now it's time to open Photoshop and play around with the different pics we saved. Some of you asked how I came up with the different designs of the drawings I've already shown you, and there is not a big secret behind it. I always spend a lot of time on Photoshop trying to fit all the pics I saved. Well, not all the pics, because there are a lot of them, but I try to see which ones work better together and which design I end up liking the most. As you can see, I don't even bother to do a good job cutting out the peaks, since this is just a reference and I'll adjust all the details when I start drawing. Oh, and something that creates a bit of controversy in the world of artists. Yes, I use grids for drawing. Okay, so now we have our reference peak, it's time to start drawing. First step I do whenever I'm drawing with coffee is doing a previous sketch with brown pencil, using the grid as a guide to place the drawing on the paper. So for drawing, I use, as I said, a brown pencil. I use polychromos, exactly the number 280. For paper, I use basic paper for watercolors from Canson, grain 370. When I'm drawing, I don't usually follow any particular order, but if you want advice from someone who has messed up so many drawings for not doing this, please start with the face. Eyes, nose and mouth, or mouth, nose and eyes, whatever order you want, because mistakes with other parts of the body are easier to fix, but with the face, once you've messed it up, there is no turning back point. And here I'm clearly not doing that, and I started this drawing with the hair. Once I finish the sketch, I move on to the fun part, the coffee. So this is gonna be a bit long, but I hope you can understand the process I follow. So more or less a week before using the coffee, if it is winter, or a couple of days if it is summer, I make coffee and leave it settle. This is the important part when we are trying to get the darker tones, because if you don't leave it settle, it is gonna be a bit difficult to get that tones, those tones.
I use instant coffee and mix the powder with different quantities of water. I use the brand Nescafe, but you can use whatever brand you have at home. So for coffee, the difficult tones to get are the darkest ones. So to get those, what I do is I add a lot of powder to the water, and that plus leaving it settle gives me those tones. For the medium light tones, you won't need to leave it settle, since those tones are the ones from a normal watery coffee. So I don't know how to explain this, but I know the coffee is ready to use when it is like a cream but still a bit liquid, since you have to paint with it. So what I usually do is I take a brush and see how dark it paints, and if I like it, I use it already, and if I don't, I leave it settle for a couple of days or a couple of hours. It is like a process where you have to check how it is, and maybe if you see that it is too liquid and it is taking too long to settle, what I do is I add more powder. So that's it. I have now the coffee. I take out the brushes and then I start painting with it like it was watercolors. You can erase it, you can add more water. So all we have to do now is just have fun. Some more details with a white gel pen, and this is the final piece. Something I got asked a lot is what I do to make it shine, and I don't do anything. That is the coffee itself, that when it is dry it shines. Last step would be protecting it with a protecting spray for watercolors, and this is the end of all the steps I follow when I'm drawing with coffee.
Este es el dibujo terminado. Todavía huele a café. Y este es el spray que uso para protegerlo, y es el que he hecho referencia antes en el vídeo. Así que nada, aquí lo dejo.